You know what? I'm going to bring you along after all. So, go ahead and pull the tailstock. Quarter turn on it. Try to do a quarter turn on all of them so that I'm about in the same location. All the teeth are open to the same. So it's a 10 millimeter. Nut back here, and there's four of them. I'm going to just spin them off and catch them as they come down. Holding the stock on. Spinning those off. Yep, and there goes one. Okay. I'm acting like that's heavy. It is pretty heavy. I only have two nuts. We'll get those screwed back on these studs immediately before they end up in the Hoover hose. Well, there's three nuts. There's not four. What the hell am I talking about? Man, where did the third nut go? Ah, there it is, standing up proud back here underneath. I always try to put the nuts on the same direction each time, too. I'm not sure if it matters or not. There's some letters, H or something, stamped on the face of those. But that's the four-jaw. This is the three-jaw with a piece of stock in it. I'm not sure if you can see that or not. Just comparing sizes here. Yeah. Quite a bit. We can get a weight on that. Got my handy Power Zero, my handy fisherman's friend. Okay, figure out a way to hop onto it. Pounds, 1 ounce. This one is coming in at 2 pounds, 13 ounces. So 8 pounds, 5 pound difference between those two chucks. It's pretty crazy. Probably not advisable to run that chuck in this little bitty mini lathe. Okay, so I got some get that dusted off a little bit in there. Okay. I think we're gonna lose this insert. Go back to maybe try some high speed steel. Okay, back with the back with the tailstock. There's no pressure on that live center while I'm tightening the tailstock, so it's not influenced by anything. Okay, let's bring this down and see if we can't get it squared to the spindle. Okay, I like that. I have another piece of known material that I'll use too from time to time. Yeah, I need to work on this thing. And I like that also. Okay, so I'm going to need to adjust my carriage a little bit, find out where my movement's at. Okay, feels like my Gibbs are all right. It all feels pretty good, actually. just a little tight when I roll it down this direction. Okay, let's pick out a tool. This tool usually gives me pretty good results. I should, looks and feels pretty good. Maybe we can install any sharpening and honing. Okay. Okay, let's see what that looks like spinning. Okay, I'm a 10,000th off the edge here. I'm just going to run that down and see what I run into down this way. Get some oil on that next time I run by that copper. I believe we'll be cutting a pretty fair amount once we get down here. You know, I don't think that's the right height. Let me check that tool height, just a smash and grab kind of way here. No, that's, if it was off, it was going to be way off. Okay. I'm going to run this down by hand until I get this thing close to being through. The whole running on centers thing probably isn't going to work. Bring you back when I get it cleaned up. Okay, I'm going to try to make this my final pass. I'm literally going to try to do 1.5 thousandths. Maybe just one. That's going to put me at 20.5. And this thing just went all over the place. I don't know where I'm at now. Hopefully that's no more than 2 thousandths. Probably won't even touch. I'd say that's 1 thousandth or less. Looks like I have one more pass to make. Hoping we can get past this copper. Pretty happy with that. I'm gonna soften up this file does so much nicer. I can't hang that up looking like that. Okay, that's a mission almost completed. What I'll more likely do, I still have a little bit of a void. Hell, I may end up taking this thing off, taking it apart, and rehoning it. I don't know. Not sure if you can make that out right there. But it disappears right here. And then reappears right here, just briefly. will get some sandpaper on here and probably take this up to start at 400 and take it up to 1500. Let's see what that's going to look like. In the meantime, what do I do with this tool post and carriage? I run it down here. Yeah, that's good. Okay, let me look and see what I have here. It's the wrong... Don't wear microfiber around your lathe. Not microfiber, fleece. Because it is a chip magnet. And it's not like I can walk by a magnet and clean it off with the brass on there. Okay, go find some automotive sandpaper. Be right back. Let this thing. It never really got very hot. Okay, I got as much of the oil removed as possible, and I have some 400 and some 1000 and nothing in between. So let's start with the 400. We'll do wet sand when we get to the 1000. Needs a little bit of work. It might be more than this 400 can do. I guess those lines you're seeing is the chatter. Gotta be the tool. Looks like the 400 might take it off. Because I don't have any patience. Let me try getting it wet. We're gonna go right to the
1,000.
See what Scotch Brite does. I tell you what, it feels good. I'm not sure if Scotch Brite is going to take away from the finish or add to it. Is that, you know, how does that equate to 1,000 grit? Scotch Brite scratched it. Let's try 1,500. Okay, be right. Okay, let me go get a little water on this. Thank you. sure you can imagine. It's not as dramatic as I thought it might be. Try putting some polish on it. I guess that's as good as it's going to get. Still not real happy with this void right here. You could probably turn that out of that. Hear that? But it's only about a half inch of that total diameter. Polish did interesting things with that aluminum. Well, I guess that's the conclusion of quad metal. Thanks for hanging around. Please like and subscribe.